Welcome to one of Dr. Piercy's Bits, a short video to explain the deployment descriptor, or web.xml file, which is found in dynamic web applications that you create using Eclipse. On the very last page of the dialog for creating a new dynamic web project in Eclipse, you'll find the Generate Web.xml deployment descriptor option. A deployment descriptor describes how a component, module, or application should be deployed to the server. If you'd like to include a web.xml deployment descriptor file in your project, you need to check it. Once your project is created, you'll be able to access the web.xml file in one of two ways. If you look at the Project Explorer, you'll notice a listing of the deployment descriptor at the top level of your application. You can also find the deployment descriptor if you drill down into the Web Content folder and then into the Web Inf folder. You'll see a file called web.xml. This is the actual file for the deployment descriptor. Double-click on either of those to see the deployment descriptor and to edit it. In our editor, we now see the web.xml, also known as the deployment descriptor. I'm currently viewing the web.xml in what is known as the source view. Notice at the bottom of the editor, you'll see two tabs. One says design, the other says source, and currently the source is selected. This is how the file would look if you opened it in a text editor. The markup, or the tags, are in the format of a data language known as XML, which stands for Extensible Markup Language. XML is a way to format data in a light way that can be sent across networks over HTTP, but still provide some structure. One thing you can notice as we look at the source view, the only thing in our web.xml is a list of what are known as welcome files. The welcome file list provides the names that you can use to name the default file for your application. So when you run your project, if it includes one of these file names in the root, that will be the one that automatically runs. Let me show you real quick how we can edit the source view. I usually like to use index.jsp or index.htm for my default files. So let me clean it up by taking out one of these files, just highlight it and hit delete. Be sure to save. So we can edit our web.xml file in the editor at the source view. Let's click on the tab for design and just see another way of looking at this same information. Here's the design view. Sometime go and compare what you see here in this listing with what is in the source. This is simply another view. I can actually edit in here as well. Let's select welcome file default.htm. Let's right click and hit remove. We'll see that that is gone. I'm going to go ahead and do that a couple more times. So I wish only to allow either index.htm or index.jsp files to be the welcome file, and I have cleaned out my welcome file list of anything else that was automatically generated. As you can see, I did the final edits using the design view. One quick look back at source, and I can see that the same two files are all that are left. When the server attempts to run your application, one of the first things it will do is to access the web.xml file and make sure that it's deploying your application to the server following any rules that you specify in this file. For more information about the concepts discussed in this video, please visit the references shown here. This video was written, narrated, and produced by Dr. Craig A. Piercy. Background music is locally sourced by Jason Farnham from the YouTube Audio Collection. This has been a Piercy production.